Hi everyone, welcome to Think Smart Home. If you have seen my previous videos, you might have noticed that I have used Synology DSM extensively in my tutorials. Synology DSM is a powerful NAS operating system with tons of features and applications. If you want to know more about DSM, I'll leave the link to their website down in the description below. In today's video, I'll show you how you can install Synology DSM on your PC. It should work on most of the old PCs sitting around at your home. I did create this tutorial a couple of months ago, and you guys seem to be enjoying it a lot, so which is why I thought to just do a tech refresh of the same tutorial, so that you can enjoy new features and options in the loader, like using the addons, then updating the loader to the latest version, which then should support a new release of DSM 2. So what do we need? We need to download and configure the ARC loader from GitHub repository. This is a very powerful loader with tons of features and add-ons. Best of them all is it's all GUI based, and most of you will not have to use command line interface. I would recommend to support the developer if you really like his work. Then we also need to download the utility called Rufus. I'll leave the download link in the description below. We will use this utility to bundle the loader into USB stick and create a bootable USB. Then we will boot our PC using the USB stick and we'll configure and build the loader using the GUI interface, which will fake our hardware into Synology hardware. It is highly recommended to use a fast USB to avoid kernel panic issues. Alright, so let's get started with the tutorial. Go to ARC loader GitHub page. I have left the link to that page down in the description below. You can select the file format to download which suits your setup. Since I am going to install DSM on bare metal, so I'll select an image file. There are other options as well if you want to run the DSM as a virtual machine. I have already downloaded this file, so I'll use that loader file to burn using Rufus utility. To burn the image file, just plug in your USB stick into your PC and run the Rufus utility as an admin. It should automatically pick up your USB stick. All you have to do now is just browse the path to the loader and leave everything as default and click on start. It will give you a warning that all data on the USB stick will be destroyed. That's fine, click OK. This might take a while to burn the loader into USB drive. While this is happening, please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel. Also press the bell icon to get notified when I release a new video about smart home automations or home network security and storage. Alright, so now the format is complete. Click close and then remove the USB stick from the PC. Plug this USB stick into your PC which you want to use as Synology NAS and boot it using the USB drive. I'll take you over to my lab to show you how the setup will look like. So here we are in my server cabinet. I have plugged in the USB drive to my old HP Z800 workstation. We will be booting this machine using the USB drive. I have already adjusted the boot sequence setting to boot from the USB. We don't need to do anything in here until we see the IP address assigned screen. Please be advised, the network connection should be wired as the wireless connection is not supported at the moment. If everything goes well, the loader will boot up and IP address will be assigned to our newly created NAS. So we can just use the IP address to build the loader. Please take a note of the IP address. Let the loader do its thing until you see ARC loader menu. We can continue the setup here, or we can also access the same interface from our PC. I'll do the remaining steps from my PC. To do that, just browse the IP address which was displayed on the screen when the loader booted up, followed by the port number 7681. It will take you to the loader menu. Here you can use both mouse and keyboard to navigate or make any selection. We select the first option to configure the loader. You can also use update option to update the loader in future with new releases, which should enable you to install latest version of DSM. For now, we'll stick to basic step, so let's select the first option, which is to choose model. I'll select RS-421 XS Plus since I am using this one already. You can select any model which suits your need. Select Show All if you need to see more options for the model. Please note some of these might still be under beta. Next, choose the DSM version. Now, select option 2 to use any random serial number. If you want, you can select option 1 and use ARC patch to use Sino services. Then select option 1 if you want to use a real Mac of your hardware, or option 2 or a custom or fake Mac. Then you can select loader add-ons. I'll recommend sticking to the basic add-ons unless you really know what you are doing here. I'll leave the default selected here and click OK. Confirm the add-ons you have selected, then click OK again. Once you are happy with the selection, select option 1. If you want to go back and make the changes, then select option 2. I select option 1, a config summary will be displayed. Once I hit OK, it will fetch the DSM pad file link from Synology website. Hit enter again and a build process should start. Give it some time until you see a confirmation build is done and boot the system now. Hit enter. This will reboot the PC. Let's go back to my server cabinet again and have a look at the boot messages again. As soon as you see loader mode selection screen, use your down arrow key to change the selection. If this is not done within 5 seconds, the system will boot with the first entry ARC DSM mode selected. Purpose of showing you this is just to let you know about the additional options you have for troubleshooting just in case you need them. Now the second selection here is to update the loader config like we just did before the reboot. The third option is just to update the loader to the latest release. Then we have DSM recovery mode and then the DSM reinstall mode. Since we have already configured and built the loader, so I select the first option and boot the loader into DSM mode. I'll hit enter and leave the loader alone for some time until it says the interface will not be operational. Here you can see the IP address assigned to the PC followed by the port number. Using this IP address and the port number, you should be able to access the DSM web interface. Once you do that, you should see a new Synology station detected. In your case, it should be a fresh install and you can simply click on install. In my case, since I was already using this PC as Synology NAS using DS3622 XS Plus, so it is detecting the existing installation. Once I click migrate, it will ask me for the installation method to keep settings and files. I don't want to keep the settings, so I'll go for the second option. But if you are migrating from any other model, then make sure to select the first option to keep the settings. If you are installing DSM for the first time on this PC, then this step is not applicable for you. Click Next. It will directly ask you to either browse to your DSM pad file if you have downloaded it manually. I'll leave the link to the download portal in the description below. Or you can select to automatically download a DSM file from Synology server for the model which you selected while building the loader. I'll select this option and then click Next. This might take some time because it will be downloading DSM and then installing it on your PC. Now the DSM installation is complete, so it's just rebooting the PC to load up the DSM. Please be advised, since this DSM is not installed on official Synology hardware, so you will not have any support from Synology if something goes wrong. So it is not recommended to use this for your production applications or services. You can use this one for your test or lab setups or maybe for the backups. I highly recommend to buy a real Synology hardware if you plan to host your critical data on it. Alright, so it's ready to go. You should see a welcome to DSM 7.2 message. click on start, give your NAS a name, and then create an admin account with admin name and password. You can check this box if you want. It will display the NAS into your Synology web assistant to help you find it in case if the system reboots and different IP addresses assigned by DHCP. Click next. Now on this page, you need to select an option for update. Since this loader is purely for DSM 7.2, so in next update of the DSM, this loader might stop working. So to avoid it, I'll suggest selecting the third option, which will not install any DSM update automatically, and you can pick and install the updates which you want. You can safely update the DSM after updating your loader if the supported loader version is released for the subject DSM version. Click next. Since this is not an official Synology hardware and we haven't installed ARC patch either, so you will not be able to use these services which are coming from Synology. So you can skip these. You can leave device analytics option unchecked and click submit. It might take some time for the setup to complete. Once that's done, you should have access to the NAS. You can configure it the way you want. Install the packages from Package Center as well. Importantly, go to Storage Manager and verify all your hard drives. Just to make sure, you can see all your hard drives which are part of your PC and they are displayed inside the Storage Manager. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you liked it. Please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you in next video.